So, Terminator 2 in 3D. I've just gotten out of a screening of Terminator 2 in real D 3D, the 4K 3D conversion of the epic science fiction film. It's being exclusively shown in AMC theaters here in North America, and I just got out of the Barton Creek AMC theater here in Austin, Texas. It's actually the first time I've been here. It's the first time I've been to an AMC theater since, my God, since maybe about 2011 when I saw Tron Legacy. Very nostalgic because I actually saw Terminator 2 when it originally came out at an AMC theater. I still have the ticket stub from all those years ago. And I can still remember that 35mm screening. I remember the trailer that played at the beginning of the film for that that horrible Gene Wilder, Richard Pryor film, Another You, the last Gene Wilder, Richard Pryor film. I remember that vividly. And there were other trailers too, I'm sure. I don't really remember that. But I remember the movie. It made such an impact on me. And watching the film theatrically again is incredible. This is not really a film designed for 3D, but even the 2D compositions of James Cameron, they're so dynamic. It's more about very subtle depth. This film is wall-to-wall action. And I mean the beginning of the film, which is just like this post-apocalyptic war between man and machine, it really, the 3D really sucks you in there. And then, throughout the film, the opening scene with the T-800 with Schwarzenegger, where he's in the honky-tonk bar, it's really playing with you. And then it seemed like, all the main battle scenes, lots of 3D stuff. The colors are pretty much, it surprised me, because everybody was worried that it was going to get this kind of orange and teal look. The colors look very, to me, almost shockingly true to the way they looked in 35mm. It's a very bright, beautiful 35mm film, and you really still feel that. The soundtrack is still wonderful, and the movie, you just still get wrapped up in the movie. I think really the beginning of the film with that opening assault, and the very end in the refinery where you have all of these sparks and things in the depth, I think it really helped the very end of the film as well. And the film looks very crisp and clean. And I think when you see a 4K Blu-ray or Ultra Blu-ray release, UHD release of the new transfer, I think you'll even be able to see it a lot cleaner. Because watching it in 3D, I usually avoid 3D. But this was, it's an epic experience. It's to watch this in 3D, they put a lot of love into it. But it's very subtle. The 3D is very subtle. And there's not too many big gimmicky shots that I really realize. It's very subtle. And it's the theatrical cut as well. So we don't get that scene where she takes the back off of the T-800 and threatens to smash it. She's like, no, And we don't get that extra scene of the orderly, beating up Linda Hamilton. And we don't get some of that stuff. But the theatrical cut does move. It does truck. And this film, I mean, it just, it's, we're still trying to catch up to this masterwork, of action science fiction, the archetypal action science fiction film. I can't, you all know it, you love it, but if you have a chance to see it in real D, in a real theater, it's just wonderful. If I had my way, this would be like a perennial. I think it's still, even though it's kind of aged, it kind of hasn't. it's still timeless. It still works. It's still, you know, the story, the character, the visual effects, they're so imaginative and so well executed that they just, you know, start, and especially this whole idea of the T-1000, of this liquid metal machine, it's still fresh and new, and it's still kind of like when the T-1000 slams against the wall and it reverses itself automatically, and it you know, weird things like that. It still picks you and, you know, takes you through it. It's such a cool, great movie. So I know, I think it has a, I think this Real D is getting a lot of a larger release in Europe and other countries, is in China, and it's being exclusively shown at AMC theaters here in North America, and I really wanted to check it out before it disappears. The theater, I saw it in Real D with reserve seats with recliners, and I talked previously about the recliners for the Cinemark theaters. The theater, first of all, is great. The Real D AMC theater, it's a tiny little theater, but it's a cute little theater. It's a cozy little theater. And there were only about 5 people in the screening. And I had the whole, I had this, they, and they were on the top rows, and I was kind of on the mid, and that was like perfect. I was like dead center. It was wonderful. And the other thing with 3D, you have to be very careful where you sit and how you perceive the effect. I thought it was in a good spot. Generally, I don't know. I'm not a 3D nut, but the recliners were incredible. The recliners were beat the pants off of Cinemark's recliners. They're a little smaller, but they go all the way back. It's like you, with the Cinemark recliners, they only go like this, you know, at full. The AMC recliners go all, like you could. It's comfortable. It's comfortable, man. They go comfortable as hell. Comfortable as hell. And the armrests are smaller, and they flip up. Okay? I don't know what's going on with Cinemark. They need to take some tips from AMC. They flip up. So problem solved. So if you're here with your girl, your partner, who they may be, they flip up. You're enjoying each other, you're enjoying the movie, you're enjoying the recline, and a wonderful luxury experience, truly a luxury lounger. So, A+ to that for AMC for doing that, at least here at the Barton Creek, Austin, Texas location. So, wonderful movie, incredible experience, and wonderful recliners, which is very important because the luxury loungers at Cinemark, they are the pits. They're not good. This is much better.